Hello viewers, welcome back to our YouTube channel Don Bosco School Tinsukia. Today I will discuss about circles. Here are some points, some important points related to circles. So our first point is a tangent to a circle is a line that intersects the circle at only one point. Try to get the meaning of this statement. A tangent to a circle is a line that intersects the circle only at one point. So there is a circle, say it is a circle, and here we can see this line AB, it is a line intersects the circle at one point. The name of this point is here P. So if we get such a situation that a line is intersecting the circle only at one point, then we can call that line as tangent. So here AB is a tangent. So this tangent we can name it as APB, considering this point also where it is touching or intersecting the circle. Otherwise we can name it as AB also. Simply AB is a tangent, or we can say that APB is a tangent. So second point is the point at which a tangent intersects a circle is called its point of contact. Once again, let's see this diagram here. This tangent APB, or simply AB, intersecting the circle at which point? P point. So this P point is called as point of contact. That is telling in this second point. So point of contact, it is nothing but the point at which the line intersecting the circle, or the tangent intersects the circle, that one. Third point is, if a line intersects a circle at two points, then it is called a secant. Mind this word, secant, S-E-C-A-N-T, secant. So get the difference between this tangent and secant, this diagram. So it is telling if a line, here the line's name is say AB, if a line intersects a circle at two points, name of these two points are A and B. So here the line AB intersects the circle at two points A and B, then it will be called as secant, S-E-C-A-N-T. So the basic difference between a tangent and a secant is, in case of tangent, the line intersects the circle only at one point, but in case of secant, the line intersects the circle at two points. So that is the basic difference between secant and tangent. And one more thing you have to remember, that this tangent, it is a special case of secant. This is a secant, this line intersecting the circle at two points, if we bring it down, pushing it down little, we'll get a time where the line will intersect or touch the circle only at one point. And then that same line will become a tangent. So secant, if we pushing it down, after that, once you will touch only one point instead of two, the same line will become then a tangent. So the basic difference is secant, the line intersects the circle at two points, and tangent, the line intersects the circle at only one point. Let's move to the next point. Next point, it is telling a circle can have infinitely many tangents. To a circle, many tangents we can draw. From different points, we can draw many tangents. Suppose this is the circle. Now, from here, we can draw here one tangent. We can draw here another tangent. From here, like this, we can draw one tangent. From this, here only, like this, we can draw any tangent. So we can say that a circle can have infinitely many tangents. Many tangents can be drawn to a circle. Then we'll take one more point. Okay, our next point is the tangent at any point of a circle is perpendicular to the radius through the point of contact. Try to get the meaning of this statement. The tangent at any point of a circle is perpendicular to the radius through the point of contact. So let us take one tangent at first. We have drawn one circle and one tangent. Let us draw. let AB be a tangent and where P is the point of contact. It is telling the tangent at any point of a circle. At any point of a circle means this tangent AB we have drawn, which is intersecting the circle at the point P. Any point of a circle is perpendicular to the radius. Mind the words, is perpendicular to the radius through the point of contact. So at the point of contact, if we draw one radius, so radius is a line segment which we get on joining center to any point of a circle. So here we have to take that any point as P point, that point of contact. So OP is a radius. Now as per this point, or this is considered as theorem also, the tangent at any point of a circle is perpendicular to the radius through the point of contact. So this tangent AB, it is perpendicular to OP. So this is the most important point. We have to apply this property or this theorem for solving many problems based on circles. So let us solve, or let us prove it. Let us prove how this theorem is correct. So we are going to prove this statement. So let AB be a tangent to a circle having center O. Let AB, as I have already told, this tangent's name I can give it as APB also. Using three letters also we can give, or using two letters also we can give the name. So let AB be a tangent to a circle, tangent to a circle having center. What is the name of the center? It is O. Let P be the point of contact. Let P be the point of contact. Then what to prove? As per this statement, what is telling? The tangent at any point of a circle is perpendicular to the radius through the point of contact. So to prove what? We have to prove that tangent, namely AB, is perpendicular. So perpendicular symbols can be given like this, perpendicular to the radius through the point of contact. So what is the name of the radius here? Yes, it is OP. So AB is perpendicular to OP. This thing we have to prove here. For this we need some construction. So construction, we'll have to mark a point, say Q, on AB. A point Q is marked. A point Q is marked on AB. And this point's position Q is, it should be other than P, not on the P we cannot mark. Other than this point P, on this line AB, anywhere we can mark this point Q. So a point Q is marked, on AB. Then let us join O and Q. O and Q are joined. O and Q are joined. O and Q are joined. And when we join O and Q, clearly we can see that OQ is intersecting the circle at one point. Let us give the name, that point of intersection as R. So let OQ intersects the circle at R. O and Q are joined, and let OQ intersects the circle. Intersects the circle at, what is the name? At R. R is the point at which that OQ line segment intersects the circle. Let me to erase this. Okay, now our proof, we can start. Here we can see that OR it is less than OQ. Can you say why OR is less than OQ? Because Q point, it is lying outside the circle. OR is a part of OQ line segment and Q is lying outside the circle. So since OR is a part of OQ, so we can say that OR is less than OQ. And at the same time, OP and OR, they will be equal. OP and OR equal. So we can write here like this at first. Here, OP equal to OR. OP equal to OR. Why? Why are they equal? OP and OR, why are they equal? They are equal because they are the radii of the same circle. Reason we can write radii of the same circle. Radii, it is the plural of radius. Radii of the same circle. Since OP and OR is the radii of the same circle, so they are equal. Again, let us give it as number 1. Again, since Q point is lying outside the circle, Q point is lying outside the circle, so OR it is less than OQ. Again, since the point Q, since the point Q is lying outside the circle, outside the circle, so what? So we'll get OR, it is less than OQ. So OR, it is less than OQ. Because OR, it is a part of OQ. Because OR is a part of OQ. Here, as a reason, we can write OR is a part of OQ. OR is a part of OQ. Any part of a complete thing is always less than the complete thing. For example, if we talk about our school compound, here any classroom, if we take classroom's area, will be always less than whole school compound's area. So just like that, OR, it is a part of OQ. And so OR is less than OQ. So this implies, now in place of OR, what can be written? What can we write in place of OR? In place of OR, we can write OP. Because in number 1, we have got OP and OR are equal. So in place of OR, now we'll write OP. So OP is less than OQ by using 1. So far we have got here that OP is less than OQ. OP is less than OQ. So what our main aim is to prove that this AB is perpendicular to OP. The tangent is perpendicular to OP, and so far we have gone that OP is less than OQ. So OP is less than OQ, and this will be true for any position of Q. This condition, OP is less than OQ, it is true for any position of Q. This is true for any position. Any position of Q other than P. Try to get the meaning of this line. This is true. This is true means we are talking about OP is less than OQ. So this is true for any position of Q, whatever may be the position of Q. Q we are taking here, or Q if we take Q here, or this left side also we can move here, anywhere. Whatever may be the position of Q other than P. Q cannot come exactly on P. If Q comes exactly on P, then OP cannot be less than OQ, then OP and OQ, they will be equal. So it is written that this is true for any position of Q other than P. So point Q cannot come on P. Other than P, anywhere if you take this point Q, then we will get this statement true. OP will be always less than OQ. So this is true for any position of Q other than P. But we know that, that means what? That means OP is the shortest distance. OP is the shortest distance. That means OP is the shortest distance. OP is the shortest distance of the line AB from the point O. OP is the shortest distance of the line AB from the point O. Try to get the meaning of this line. So at first we have got that this is true for any position of Q, whatever may be the position of Q, this OP will be always less than OQ. We have got here at first. Then here in this statement it is telling that means OP is the shortest distance among all the distances. If we go on drawing like this some more distances for different positions of Q, if we draw among all those positions, let me to draw this, then you will understand more nicely. Say here Q position, or Q here, or Q here, wherever if we take Q. So among all these different positions, among all these different positions of Q, OP is the shortest distance. So this thing it is explaining here, that means OP is the shortest distance of the line AB, of the line AB from the point O. So from the point O, OP is the shortest distance. But we know that among all the distances, the perpendicular distance, of a line from a given point is the shortest Try to get the meaning of this line. So we have got here that OP is the shortest distance of the line AB from the point O. We don't know here whether OP is perpendicular or not. We have come to a conclusion so far here up to this much that OP is the shortest distance for different positions. If we take Q, among all the positions, OP distance that means this distance of this line AB from the center O, OP is the shortest distance. We don't know whether perpendicular or not. Now look at this statement here, what is telling. But we know that among all the distances, the perpendicular distance of a line, mind this word, the perpendicular distance of a line from a given point, is the shortest. So there is a fixed point here and there is a line. Different distances are there from here. Say here one distance, OP one distance, here OQ one distance, OR one distance. Like this, different distances, all are different distances. So among all these distances, the perpendicular distance is the shortest one. So here this symbol means what? Here OP, here name is not OP, OR it is written here, say, or anything else we can take, say OS at this point. So OS is perpendicular here, and so this will be the shortest distance. So if a line is shortest distance, if a distance of a line from a fixed point is shortest, in that case that line should be perpendicular. So that thing this statement is telling. We know that among all the distances, the perpendicular distance of a line from a given point, so here given point is O. So among all the distances, I drew few minutes ago here different lines. So among all those distances, this perpendicular distances is the shortest one. Here we have come to know that this distance is shortest, that means that OP is the shortest distance. We have come to know OP is the shortest distance, and to become the shortest distance, OP should be perpendicular. To become the shortest distance, OP should be perpendicular, and that thing is explained in this statement. So we have got that among all the distances, the perpendicular distance of a line from a given point is the shortest. So what? Hence this OP is perpendicular to AB. Hence OP is perpendicular to AB. And that thing only we are asked to prove, that tangent radius is perpendicular to the tangent, or tangent is perpendicular to the radius at the point of contact, same thing. So we have got, hence OP is perpendicular to AB, proved. So this proof is quite logical, no much calculation is there, no arithmetic calculation, only some statements logically we put, and then from there we have got that the radius is perpendicular to the tangent at the point of contact. This is very important from examination point of view. Often this question comes to prove that this statement you will be given, and if it comes, it carries 2 to 3 marks. I hope you have understood this theorem nicely, and it will help you for writing your exam. Thank you for watching our video. We'll meet soon. Bye bye.